of all the fights you've been to at the, you know, over the years, the in the 50s, 60s, 70s, 80s, whatever, any fight you was ringside at that you watched and you still recall with fond memories, if we went back in time again and two ringside tickets, me and you, which one would you take me back to?
Well, you might think this is there was something that happened in Liverpool for the atmosphere that was unbelievable. It was when Shea Neary fought Andy Holligan, when he had to put the big tent up on the park. The atmosphere that day was something else. That was a fight, because the round before Shea got the better of Andy, Andy looked as if he was going to take over. And it was a tremendous... The atmosphere that day, you could cut it with a knife. I do believe, I don't know, but I do believe there was a little bit of trouble between factions in Liverpool. Nothing to do with the boxing. People who supposedly fell out with each other, or a bit of a turf war or something. But I believe they had an amnesty for the week of the fight. But it was one hell of a... That was a hell of a fight there. It was a good fight, but you have to be there.
I could have
to feel
it was in a tent, wasn't it? It was in a big circus tent thing that they
constructed.
That's right,
yes.
I remember the atmosphere, watching on TV. The fight was fantastic as well. Them two.
Oh, yeah.
Were the two best,
if you had been inside the tent, there was it was red hot. Now, it was a cold night outside. But it was as if it was bloody roasting in there. Going to happen that night.
Here are the contestants, fighting out of the blue corner. The challenger is wearing the black and gold trunks and weighing up 10 stone exactly. It is a staggering 29 fight record, 27 wins, 19 by Will Nark, and only two defeats. He's a former British and Commonwealth light-welterweight champion and former world title contender from the Phoenix Gym and the beautiful city of Liverpool, the Hunter, Andy Holligan. Across the ring, fighting out of the red corner, is the champion. He's wearing the black trunks. He weighed at 9 stone 13¾ pounds. He brings an undefeated professional record of 18 contests, 18 wins, 15 by way of knockout. He's the first undefeated World Boxing Union, the light-welterweight champion of the world, from the beautiful and double, making his second defense. She, the Shamrock Express, Neary.
No love lost between these two. This is a big all Liverpool fight. First round, and the challenger, Andy Holligan, in the black shorts, and the champion also in black shorts. On the right now, Shea Neary, the champion.
Shea Neary, the one with the hair, I think,
yes.
Is probably the easiest way to tell them apart.
Well, both of these fighters straight into the action. There's not going to be any feeling out stages during this fight. This is going to be a war.
As was proved by the lengthy rendition of Ferry Across the Mersey, a sort of city anthem to go with the national anthem. This is more than a world title fight. More important than that is the championship of Liverpool.
Good body punch from Holligan. Well, I hope this fight carries on like this, but it started with a tremendous pace.
So I think there are a few who actually expected to go 12 rounds, and certainly they've started off as though neither of them has that in mind.
Very accurate hooking from both men, good solid shots. Defensively, both men are not very good at the moment because they're both getting through. And these are two solid hitters.
Neary getting the jab through there well, and that might be an important weapon in the course of this contest.
Holligan decides to start jabbing himself. And invariably it does tend to be that the jab can be a very, very influential punch when two fighters come close together like this. Good shots from Holligan.
There's certainly no feeling out going on here. This is straight down to business.
Both of these men possess one-punch knockouts. This could be over at any stage. Good shots from Neary, and I think he hurt Holligan there slightly. An amazing first round. Head's getting a bit dangerous there too.
Yes, there's been a touch of the rutting stags about them, and the referee's already spoken to both men, but I don't think they're going to take too much notice of him. There's bragging rights on Merseyside at stake here.
This is Neary's first fight for a year now. He's been champion since October 96, and it's with, well, Holligan shown superb punching power, but back comes Neary. This was the style right the way through that first round. But look at the heads there, and that, I think, is going to cause a cut if they're not careful. The referee will do well to separate these two.
Billy Graham being fairly emphatic about what he wants from Holligan there.
Well, I heard the left jab.
Oh, left it was, was it?
It was left jab.
That was the word I missed.
Second round, the champion Shea Neary on the right with the red hair, Andy Holligan. Oh, great round up with the left top. Taken very well by Holligan.
As however he described it, I think Graham had it right. He does need to get that jab working, because otherwise if he's letting Neary come in close, he's going to feel a few of these uppercuts.
Oh, good left hand work from the champion. That's what he needs. Oh, right hand from Holligan. This surely can't go on like this for much longer. One of these two great boxers has got to give.
You can guarantee that that both will be as fit as they've ever been. This is a long-awaited fight on Merseyside, and probably more than any other fight in their careers, maybe even Holligan against Chavez. This is the one that he's going to want to win. And they won't have skimped on training at all.
I think the difference being he believes he can win this one, where maybe against Chavez at the time, he really was. Oh, well, a superb shot from Neary. And Holligan again takes it well. His two losses have been inside the distance. We know the Chavez fight. He lost to Ross Hale, knocked out in three rounds in May 94.
And that was a fairly bad knockout. He was unwell for a while after that. In fact, spent the night under observation in the hospital. Nothing too serious, but it was a sort of knockout that does give you cause to worry about your future prospects.
Well, Ross Hale, we know, is a big, big puncher, but Neary has Holligan on the ropes here. Holligan grabs him, he's hurt. Flung to the floor. That's not a count, and the referee will not take it up. But the eyes did look glazed, Gareth.
Indeed, and I would tend to think that there was a case for giving him a count. Admittedly, he was sort of half wrestled to the floor, but it was a punch that caused his legs to buckle in the first place.
Rights and lefts raining in on Holligan. Got to fight back or hold on, do something. I would go as far as to say as the bell saved Holligan there.
Yes, that could be the case. It's certainly a big round for Shea Neary. I thought he edged the first, but I wouldn't argue too much with an even first round. But that one was definitely Neary's. And Holligan, clash of heads there, that just before he took that first left hook.
I'm surprised there aren't any cuts yet, Gareth, but he went on to do this to Holligan.
Indeed, he may not leave him around long enough to cut him. That was a good barrage by Neary, and Neary, as we know, does hold power. His one defence of the title so far was against the South African Jeremiah Malinga, and he stopped him in three. So the third round coming up, can he repeat that with Andy Holligan?
So third round. And Holligan, on the right of your picture now, was in desperate trouble that last round. He did well to make it through this. He's shown in the past, though, he's got great heart and fighting ability, too. Referee rightly telling them, but again, they go straight back in, ignoring him. Seems just to be an incredibly strong man, Shea Neary. Straight back in and banging heads together.
The gestures were probably easily comprehensible, but I'm not too sure that two Scousers are going to understand the South African accent.
Good change of angle with a left hook there from Neary. Holligan seems short on ideas at the moment. Neary winning the battle of boxing ability too.
I think to a large extent he's being allowed to. When Neary throws punches, Holligan seems prepared to just wait for the storm to blow over before coming back with his own. And he's going to need to actually make Neary think about defending himself rather more than allowing him to take the pace as he has been so far. Holligan certainly has the punching power to worry Neary, and a good right there.
Oh, tremendous right hook. But back comes Holligan, he's taken that well. There were people that doubted his ability to take a good punch. but he's proving everybody wrong tonight. Whatever happens now, we know he can take a shot. Whether he can continue to take them, that's the question. Again, Neary finishing the round very strongly. Tremendous. That's the only word to describe this. Billy Graham giving the instructions, and now we're over to the Champions Corner, the Shamrock Express, and I think Andy Holligan, the hunter, is being hunted throughout these first three rounds, or has been so far. Good right hook again there. Oh, it's a tremendous shot, Gareth.
It is. The opening created with the left and then overcomes the right before Holligan had time to react. And although he's showed he's got a good chin, there must be a question mark about how long he can go on taking punches like that.
Trying to go forward in this fourth round. Shea Neary on the right of your picture. Andy Holligan now facing you with the bald head. Holligan trying to go forward, but every now and then he's forced back, as he is being now. I think Neary the stronger all-round fighter.
Neary the younger man too, and I don't just mean that in the sense of the calendar. There's only a year between them on the calendar, but Holligan is a fairly worn fighter in that he's got a lot of miles on the clock, whereas Neary's only had 18 fights as a pro and only ever boxed 13 times as an amateur. So he's a very young 29 in a ring sense.
Been a professional for more or less only half the time of Holligan. Holligan's been a pro for 10 years. 11 years, and Holligan and Neary 5.5 years. So, as you say, the miles on the clock are much less for Shea Neary.
Certainly, if this goes into the later rounds and stamina becomes a key issue, that certainly should work in Shea Neary's favour. But Holligan coming a little bit more into it in this round, and perhaps he feels he's got over the initial assault and it's time to take over.
Good left hook to the body. One of Holligan's pet punches. But Neary just looks a bigger round, all-round fighter. Much physically the stronger man looking.
Referee very quickly in there after Neary was guilty of pulling Holligan down.
Good boxing to finish this fourth round from Shea Neary. It's been a better round for Holligan.
It has. Neary started off well and he's finishing well, but Holligan quite possibly did enough in the intervening period to take a round on the judges' scorecard.
A good fight back by Andy Holligan after being under pressure the first two or three rounds. And surprisingly, none of them are cut yet. Good punches from Neary, and again the heads come together, but neither men showing any signs, Gareth, of cuts.
No, I don't know whether they've been undergoing the old treatment of washing in brine and God knows what else that the old fighters used to do to stop cuts. But their skin seems to be standing up well to the fans.
Whatever it is, it's taken Holligan's hair off, that's for sure.
Indeed, yes. He certainly lost his last fight with his barber.
Oh, great left up. We got the start. It caught Holligan by surprise. This was always going to be a great fight. Both men have got styles to make a good fight, but really, Liverpool has been excited and building this one up for a good few months.
Yes, it's a bit of a throwback to the old days at Liverpool Stadium, now sadly demolished, the graveyard of champions, they used to call it. And since then, Liverpool's not really had a venue to hold major fights. The Everton Park Sports Centre, where Neary's had most of his career, only holds 1,200. This fight was taking place in a massive tent with 5,000 people erected in Stanley Park between Liverpool and Everton football grounds.
But it's creating
all 5,000 really enjoying themselves.
Yeah, it's a good atmosphere here. Neary needs to go back to the jab, and I think I can hear some of the cornermen shouting jab.
If the pace has slowed a little, which was pretty much inevitable. It does seem perhaps that Neary, rather surprisingly, is the more tired at this stage. Seems to be taking something of a breather there.
Good shot from Holligan. Neary is looking tired.
The referee seems to be worried about water in both corners. And
it's a good finish. Sorry, Gareth, it's a good finish from Holligan. Is that what they were trying to get rid of in the opening of the round?
I think so. I can't think what else it could have been. Certainly a good round for Holligan. And whether this possibly is the turning point of the fight, that having withstood the early barrage, Holligan is now taking command. Certainly a few problems for the people in Shea Neary's corner here to sort out.
Well, here's action, and they're saying that Neary is panicking. Keep working for Holligan, and it was working during that last round. He came back very strongly after a good start for Neary.
Yes, where Holligan had been letting Neary dictate the pace, in that round he dictated it, and Neary found it difficult to maintain. And the body shot there certainly hurt the champion.
You can see the wince on the face of Shea Neary. Sixth round, Andy Holligan on the right and the champion Shea Neary on the left. And Holligan's corner seemed very up for this round then. Keep it going, son, they said. They think he's doing well. Good shots inside from Holligan.
Neary doing better when he keeps it at distance. He's the jab is scoring well. I just don't understand why he's not throwing more of them. That's better.
Seems to have the longer reach, the champion. Well, this could end at any time with these two men putting everything into this fight. I think Neary is tiring, Gareth, and that's why he's not keeping it long range. He seems to feel more comfortable in close, although it's not working for him. He's getting caught in Holligan on the attack. Oh, good uppercut, left hook from Holligan.
And Neary coming back there.
Gum shield out, is it?
Looks like the challenger's gum shield.
And you can see the legs of Holligan, they're wobbling. And his eyes do look glazed again.
As it's one of these occasions where the corner are not going to be in too much of a hurry to get that gum shield back in. Holligan needs every second he can.
Oh, Neary putting everything into these punches now. Shots, and surely Holligan, yeah, he's got to go down from that. Badly hurt. Can he make it through? There's plenty of time left in this round. Well, I've never seen that before. An eight on the floor, and then another few seconds when he gets up to eight.
That's a long count beyond there.
Oh, and the right hand hurts him. Left hook. This is going to be all over, surely. That's it. The referee stopped it, and rightly so. Well, you've got to feel sorry for Andy Holligan. It's a great fight, one of the best fights of the year so far, if not the best. Haven't seen a fight as good as that for a long time, Gareth.
No, it was a cracker. And what made it so good, I think, was the fact that it swung one way and then the other. And we went into that sixth round thinking that Holligan was getting on top. And Shea Neary told us we were wrong.
Well, as usual, there we see Andy Holligan. He's got a very bad swelling over the right eye. That came up during the last round. And here we see the action. Shea Neary knew his man was in trouble. Great, great hooks. And that was the first knockdown.
And it was more the wise old head taking a count on one knee rather than actually being knocked over. You'll see that Holligan decides, look, I've got to get out of this blitz and I'll go down on one knee and take the eight count.
And here we see, this must be the finish. Tremendous power. Look at the back on Shea Neary. There's not an ounce of fat on him, and he puts everything into every punch there. And the referee, I think, was just waiting, and that was it. All over.
There's a perfectly timed intervention there by the South African referee, and there was no point in Holligan taking any more. He wasn't throwing punches back. He was clearly badly hurt and would have got even more badly hurt had it been allowed to continue any longer. Very impressive finish by Shea Neary. All the tiredness of the previous round vanished once he had Holligan in trouble.
There's the two boxers hugging. That's always nice to see.
Ladies and gentlemen, 2 minutes and 42 seconds on the sixth round. The referee has stopped the contest. The winner, and still undefeated, World Boxing Union's light-welterweight champion of the world, Shea, the Shamrock Express.